In the 1970 film Prem Pujari, Dev Anand plays the son of a retired war hero who is sent out to the border during the 1962 Indo-China War. Despite being an expert marksman, he refuses to lift his gun and shoot, penning poems instead, eventually turning his back on battle and running away from the scene. Court-martialed, he was humiliated and faced ridicule. An eerily similar incident happened in Kashmir when Subedar Dalbir Singh of Rashtriya Rifles Battalion did not fire at militants shooting at his company's position. These were the facts presented to the Supreme Court when it delivered its decision in July 2019. 13 years ago in August 2006, the army was conducting search and cordon operations inside a suspected militant's house in Darigudia village in Jammu and Kashmir, when suddenly, gunfire was heard in the nearby maize fields. They surrounded the location where the firing came from, while Dalbir and his colleague took positions manning a light machine gun so as to cut off the militants' escape route. After a long wait of several hours, around midnight, the militants made their move and began firing at their position. One round hit Dalbir in the leg, and just like Dev Anand in Prem Pujari, Subedar Dalbir Singh fled. Left alone, rounds hit his colleague, Sapper Gurmel Singh, killing him instantly. The militants took the now abandoned guns and escaped into the night. A second court-martial by the Arms Forces Tribunal in 2011 confirmed the earlier verdict.
Dalbir Singh, you are dismissed from service from showing cowardice in battle and sentenced to 6 months in jail under Section 34C of the Army Act.
Dalbir Singh, a soldier since 1999, appealed to them.
I have taken part in many skirmishes before and always acted honorably.
This time too, he claims.
I tried to fire my AK-47, but it got jammed. Then I got hit. After that, I jumped over a wall to shield myself from further bullets. That's when I hit my head on a stone while falling and blacked out for some time.
He called other soldiers to testify to his strength of character.
He's a good soldier. We have gone together on several skirmishes before. He has never been scared to take part in any operation.
Army tests confirmed that not only was there no jamming of his AK-47, even all bullets in his service pistol remained unfired. Most damning is the accusation that had Dalbir Singh not deserted, possibly his colleague Gurmel Singh would have survived. The Supreme Court brushed aside Dalbir's appeal for leniency, upholding his dismissal.
A soldier cannot merely live on past glory, but should be able to rise up on every occasion. There is no room for cowards in the army.
But because of his earlier service to the nation,
your prison term of 6 months is cancelled.
Can a single error be overlooked in an otherwise seemingly unblemished record? Is the soldier a machine that he has to rise up on every occasion? Even Virat Kohli got out for just one run in the all-important semi-final against New Zealand. Is that sufficient reason to remove him from Team India? The Supreme Court did address this as well.
A soldier cannot be compared with other professions that have the luxury of failing to rise to the occasion sometimes.
Subedar Dalbir Singh was paid approximately 20 to 22,000 rupees per month by the army. Now, by dismissing him, his family will also be denied pension. Historically, it was common for deserters to be executed by firing squads. The British were the most fastidious about this, while Americans and Germans were not as inflexible. Meanwhile, Dev Anand's reason for fleeing the battlefield was different. He was a man of nature and believed that problems could be solved without spilling blood. He demonstrated this when he tricked the Chinese by working as a double agent and spying important secrets for India. Hence, Prem Pujari, believer in love. But there will be no such filmy salvation for Subedar Dalbir Singh. Will there be a challenge to this judgment through a larger bench of the Supreme Court? Bisbo's Limerick. Subedar Dalbir Singh ran away from the fight. The Supreme Court ruled that it just wasn't right. He didn't rise to the occasion and defend the nation. For an act of cowardice, there is no respite. Subscribe to Bisbo's channel and be sure to click on the bell icon. Be the first to know when Bisbo releases a new video.